Hello and welcome to the channel. This is Vava. In this video, we are fixing a faulty Amaran PT2C that came with its battery completely drained and not working. As you can see, it doesn't respond to the button. When plugged into the mains, it shows 100% charge, but as soon as you unplug it, it shuts off. Here is what you'll need to disassemble: pair of needle nose pliers and some precision screwdrivers. Let's start by removing these Torx screws. Take the cap off, and inside we see the control board and two connectors, one for power and one for DMX. Unscrew the other side as well. Then gently pull the connectors out and slide out the aluminum chassis. Here's what's inside: control board, power controls, and the battery. Here are the battery specs, just basic 18650 cells. Let's pull out the battery assembly and cut out this protection sleeve. Be careful, because there is a delicate thermal sensor in here. Here's this. Now use a soldering iron to detach two cables connecting the battery to the control board. Remove these protection caps and detach the batteries from the control board. Keep as much of this contact surface as possible for future soldering. Here are random new batteries from AliExpress. These particular batteries have factory soldered nickel strips, which is helpful. Before soldering, scratch the contact surface to help the solder stick. Start by applying some solder to the contact points, then daisy chain the batteries. If you are soldering directly to the batteries, be very careful. Overheating them is dangerous. Next, apply solder to the board contact and connect the battery assembly back to the board. It's a bit fiddly, but here's the method I used. I heated up the inside of the contacts and quickly pressed them down with pliers. It took a while, but in the end, it worked. Now let's put everything back together, starting with some insulating tape over the contacts. Put the battery units into a piece of 35mm heat shrink tubing. Solder the battery assembly back to the control board. Now for a quick test. Everything works fine. Let's not forget the thermal sensor. Secure the battery using some hot glue. Tuck the cables in and slide the unit back into the tube. Put the connectors back into their slots. Now let's test it once again. The unit turns on and the charging works too. It runs for just over 2 hours at 100% in CCT mode, which seems normal. Thanks for watching. Bye!